Welcome back. Let's get the latest now on the flood emergency impacting several communities in Sydney's west, with more than 3,000 people now under emergency warnings.
Let's bring in Chief Superintendent Dallas Burns from the New South Wales SES and Hawkesbury Mayor Sarah McMahon. Thanks so much for your time, both of you. Firstly to you, Dallas, where are the main areas of concern this morning?
Yeah, we're still concerned about the Hawkesbury, but I'm pleased to say that the flood threat there is easing. However, we have around 352 dwellings under evacuation at the moment, and that impacts just under 1,000 people. We've got evacuation centres in place. However, we have seen those highs peak now, and now we're just following that water moving downstream and making sure we warn the communities in its path and prepare the appropriate warnings for those people so they know what's coming.
Are those residents under the evacuation orders, are they following the orders?
The majority are. There are some people who are isolated and are staying in place, and we know where they are. We've got resupply organised for them. However, we are finding a really high level of compliance with those requests we're putting out.
Dallas, we saw yesterday a pretty dramatic rescue with a man on his tractor. I mean, you do see instances like this in flood events. Can you understand just this heightened stress in the community, and what's your advice to them?
Absolutely. I mean, there are communities in the Hawkesbury that have been flooded multiple times over the last few years. Look, I could only feel for them. It's really hard. My own house has been damaged in this event in the Illawarra. The cleanup is significant. And it's one of those things, you can't stop a flood. It's not like a fire where you can send appliances and defend a dwelling. We've really just got to make sure we get people and their livestock out of harm's way and to higher ground or to an evacuation centre.
Well, let's go to you now, Sarah. What is the feeling like in your community right now?
The community is still very anxious. I know that the water has probably peaked and we're waiting to see how that plays out today. We'll have another update from the bomb at 11 a.m. in terms of those river heights. But people have been very stressed overnight when those evacuation warnings came in late. They needed to obviously go to the evacuation centres. That has eased this morning, but we still do have a lot of people not in their homes and a lot of people concerned about their businesses on the lowlands.
And attention now on Warragamba Dam. It could be spilling for, maybe a fortnight now. How concerning is that for the local people there?
It really is, especially as I said just a moment ago, the businesses and the farms on our lowlands, for them, they are looking at a lot of revenue lost in their crops destroyed. And as long as that water keeps spilling out of the dam, we just have no certainty. So that, of course, raises the fear and anxiety in our community.
And are people banding together? Are people helping each other where they can?
Oh, they certainly are. It's great to see our community spirit. And after six floods in the last few years, we know now what to do. So the preparation has been much better this time. And now we are turning our discussions towards cleaning up.
All right. Sarah and Dallas, thank you both so much for your time this morning and good luck with what comes ahead.
Emergency evacuations are taking place right across Sydney this morning as floodwaters rise in the city's west and northwest as well.
Across the border in Queensland, residents are on high alert with up to 100 millimetres of rain threatening to fall within hours.
We do have team coverage live this morning. First, Jack Hahn, who's monitoring the situation north Richmond, northwest of Sydney. Jack, floodwaters are raging where you are.
Yeah, they certainly are, Clint. Jane, good morning to you both. Yes, I'm joining you from North Richmond. In fact, I'm standing on the main road, usually through town, the Bells line of road, but it is closed this morning for obvious reasons. You can see it there in the distance behind us. The Richmond Bridge is closed. It is flooded. This is a bridge that connects the two communities. And this morning you can see there's an awful lot of mess on it. The trees have been twisted and turned as the river raged last night. It reached a peak of 10.52 metres last night. It has fallen this morning. It is sitting at about 8 metres nearby at Windsor. The Windsor Bridge is open. In fact, it remained open all night. There were some concerns that it may close. We saw the water just lapping right below the bridge, but it is still open for cars to pass across it. We're being told from the Weather Bureau that the major flooding alert and major flooding risk is now easing this morning. A lot of the indications showing that the rivers are either at steady or are falling this morning. We have heard from the local mayor out here. She spoke to Today on Nine earlier. Watch.
People have been very stressed overnight when those evacuation warnings came in late. They needed to obviously go to the evacuation centres. That has eased this morning, but we still do have a lot of people not in their homes and a lot of people concerned about their businesses on the lowlands.
So we still do have a number of emergency warnings in place this morning. 32 alerts are active. That is affecting close to 4,000 people out here. All of those people have been made aware by the emergency services. But if you have loved ones out here and you are worried, you can hone in on where exactly those alerts are by going onto the SES website. There are two evacuation centres open, one in Penrith, one in Richmond. Now, we know that the SES has been incredibly busy overnight, responding to 146 flood rescues like this one at Freeman's Reach. It's a story that probably won't surprise you. Someone tried driving through flood waters and they came off second best. Thankfully, they were able to walk away unhurt. There were no injuries, but their car has been totaled. So this morning, the advice is if you see flood waters, there are some roads like this, low-lying roads that are flooded. Well, if it's flooded, forget it.
Jack Hahn in North Richmond, thank you.
Live now to Ashlyn Kukelis in Brisbane. And Ashlyn, the southeast is already copping a drenching.
It is, Jane. This is the weather system that's been threatening Queensland for some days now. The rain has arrived in Brisbane. There was hardly any rainfall in the city yesterday, but it is a different story today. It's a very wet morning to wake up to. The city is a whiteout blanketed by low-lying cloud and really consistent showers. It's a similar story for anyone waking up on the Gold Coast this morning. And the Weather Bureau warns we could see heavy falls in isolated areas around 50 or 60 millimetres, which of course could cause some flash flooding. Take a look.
So while we're broadly expecting an increase in showers, heavier falls should be relatively isolated, most likely during the early morning hours around the southeast Queensland coastline if we do get a bit of a coastal trough forming.
Until now, it had been areas to the north and west of southeast Queensland being affected by this weather system. There is still a major flood warning in place for the Warrego River. It has now peaked, though, at 6.7 metres, and floodgates that were put in place have largely protected the town of Charleville. It is now the southeast turn, Brisbane's turn, to receive the rain today. The good news, though, is that conditions will ease later on today and sunshine will be back tomorrow.
Ashlyn, thank you.
Well, the good news is that the weather system that brought all of this torrential rainfall has moved away out into the Tasman Sea and the severe weather warnings have been cancelled. However, as we've just heard, those flooding impacts continue. The major flooding in the Hawkesbury, Nepean and Colo catchments have peaked and the warnings have been downgraded to a moderate flood level. But that being said, there's still an enormous amount of water that's making its way downstream, and we are expecting there to be peaks in the lower catchments throughout this morning.
And it must be said, still some concern north of the border in Queensland. What's expected there today?
Look, there's showers that are streaming across southeastern Queensland and also northeastern New South Wales as we speak, with some moderate rainfall rates being recorded there. Today, there's the risk of showers and thunderstorms across inland parts of southeast Queensland, southeast Queensland and northeast New South Wales, with the potential for heavy rainfall totals. And it should be noted that the grounds up there are really, really wet, so there remains a heightened risk for flash flooding with any moderate to heavy rainfall that does occur.